Good morning, students. We are learning chapter number 11, Work and Energy of your NCERT book. We have learned in the previous video about the gravitational potential energy and the law of conservation of energy. Now, in this video, we will be learning about the rate of work done, numericals related to power, commercial unit of energy and its related numericals. So let us start with the topic power. So what is power? Power is the rate of doing work. It means how faster or slower the work is being done is known as power. Let us consider two examples. Here you can see two pictures. In one picture, the person is riding a bicycle, and in one picture, the person is riding a bike. And both the persons have to reach the same distance or same destination. So who will travel faster? Obviously, the bike rider will travel faster and reach the destination at earlier than the bicycle traveler. Why? Because the bike rider will cover more distance or do more work in less amount of time, whereas the bicycle rider will cover less distance or does less work in less amount of time. So bike rider will reach the destination faster. In other words, we can say that the power of bike rider is more than the power of bicycle rider. So here we have the formula for power. Since the power is defined as rate of work done, by rate we mean divided by time. So power is work done by time taken, or work done divided by time taken. Since it is denoted by P, we have P equals to W, where W denotes the work done, and T as time taken. Now the SI unit of power is watt. That is, power is measured in watt. Power, we can measure power in watt. What is 1 watt? Now, 1 watt is the power of an agent or an appliance which does work at the rate of 1 joule per second. It means when any appliance is consuming 1 joule of energy or is doing 1 joule of work in 1 second, we say that the power of the appliance or power of the person is 1 watt. Power 1 watt equals to 1 joule by 1 second. That is, 1 W, we denote watt by W, equals to 1 joule per second. Now, other units of power, that is bigger units of power, we can measure power in different units are kilowatt and megawatt. 1 kilowatt equals to 1000 watt, that is 1 joule, 1000 joule by second. And 1 megawatt equals to 10 to the power 6 watt. It means 10 raised to the power 6 watt make up the 1 megawatt power. Now here is one more example. We say that a single LED has power of 1 watt. It means it consumes 1 joule of electrical energy in 1 second. Similarly, a toaster has a power of 1 kilowatt. It means 1000 watt energy is consumed in 1 second. 1000 houses, the power of 1000 houses is 1 megawatt. So, a bulb, or how much power is needed to light up 1000 houses? It is 1 megawatt. That is 10 to the power 6 watts. Similarly, a power of 1 gigawatt will lit up 10 lakh or 1 million houses. Now let us perform some numericals related to power. We will use the formula for power as W by T or E by energy. Since energy is work done, energy and work done are same. So we can also use this formula E by T for power. So first numerical, a body does 20 joules of work in 5 seconds. So work done is 20 joule. We have written work done as 20 joule. And time is 5 seconds. What is the power? Since we know that the formula for power is work done by time taken, we will put the value of work and time in the formula and we will find the answer as 4 watt. Next, an electric bulb consumes 7.2 kilojoules of electrical energy in 2 minutes. It means we have been given energy as 7.2 kilojoules and time as 2 minutes. So we will convert kilojoules into joules by multiplying it by 1000. Since 1 kilojoule equals to 1000 joules, 7.2 kilojoule equals to 7.2 into 1000 joules, that is 7200 joules. Similarly, we will convert time, which is given in minutes, into seconds. We will multiply it by 60 and we will get 120 seconds as time. Now, since the power has a formula work by time, we can also write E by T. So we will put the values of E and T in the formula and we will find the answer as 60 watt. So power of an electric bulb is 60 watt. Now, how to measure electricity? Electricity, the electric current in your house, come from the power stations and you also get a bill, electricity bill. And in the bill, which is measured by the meter of your house, we have the electricity in kilowatt hours or units. So the commercial unit of electricity is, or electric energy is, kilowatt hour. So before understanding what is kilowatt hour, let us take some examples. A 1 kilowatt toaster left on for 2 hours uses 2 kilowatt hour. So a toaster who is running for 2 hours and suppose its power is 1 kilowatt. So what is its unit of energy? 2 kilowatt hours. So 1 kilowatt toaster used for 2 hours, which is running for 2 hours, consumes 2 kilowatt of energy. Similarly, a 200 watt TV left on 5 hours. So a power of a 200 watt TV, a TV of 200 watt is running for 5 hours. It will consume 200 into 5, that is 1000 kilowatt. A 2 kilowatt kettle left for 15 minutes. We will convert 15 minutes into hour by dividing it by 60. And we will get as 1 by 2 or 0.5 kilowatt hour. So we can define the commercial unit of energy as kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour is the energy used in 1 hour at the rate of 1 kilowatt. It means 1 kilowatt hour is the energy of an appliance which is running for 1 hour and which is consuming power of 1 kilowatt. 1 kilowatt hour, let us convert this 1 kilowatt hour into joules. How we will convert 1 kilowatt hour equals to 1 kilowatt into 1 hour? 1 kilowatt means 1000 watt and 1 hour means 3600. So 1000 watt into 3600 becomes this, that is 36 lakh, or 1 kilowatt hour equals to 3.6 into 10 raised to power minus 6 joules. Now, the electric energy used in homes and industries are expressed in kilowatt hour. So how you express the electrical energy in homes and industry? In kilowatt hour or in units. It is also known as unit. 1 kilowatt hour also means 1 unit. So that was all about the commercial unit of energy. Next is numerical base and commercial unit of energy. We will use the formula 1 kilowatt hour equals to 3.6 into 10 raised to power 6 joules. You have to remember this formula always. The question can also be come that convert 1 kilowatt hour into joules. You will use this previous method for this. Now we have two numericals here. A radio set of 60 watt runs for 50 hours. So we have been given watt or power of the radio as 60 watt. It is running for 50 hours, means time is being given as 50 hours. We will convert watt into kilowatt because the question is how many units of electrical energy is consumed. We have to find the electrical energy in units. Unit, one unit means 1 kilowatt hour. So we will find the answer in kilowatt hour first, and then it will be equal to the units. So we will convert watt into kilowatt by dividing it by 1000. We get 60 by 1000 or 0.06 kilowatt. Then we have time as 50 hour, which is done. Next we have the formula for power as electrical energy by time taken. So if we have to find E, we have to take this T and multiply it by power. Power into T is electrical energy. We will put the values of power and time and we will get the answer as 3 kilowatt hour or 3 units. Similarly, we have the another numerical. A family uses 250 units of electrical energy during a month. 250 unit of electrical energy during month, it means energy is being given. Calculate this electrical energy in joules. You have to convert it in joules. So 1 unit of energy means 1 kilowatt hour. That means 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joules. 250 units of energy means 250 into 3.6 into 10 raised to power joules. Because when we have to find the value of larger things, we multiply. So we have multiply 250 by 3.6 into 10 raised to power 6 joules, and we get the answer as 9 into 10 raised to power 8 joules. Hope it is clear. So for your home assignment, you have to solve these examples and back exercises of your NCERT books, and you have to read page number 155 to 156, topic number 11.3 of your NCERT book for your better understanding. This was the last part of the chapter. Hope you have seen the other parts and understood also. We will be doing worksheets after that. Till then, take care and thank you.